In a series of videos, we are learning about HTTP client module. To learn HTTP client module, we are implementing an example to manage a list of countries. This is the architecture for this example application. So far, we have created the Angular application and we have installed JSON server. In this video, we will create the database for countries in JSON server. Let us get started with the creation of the database. In Visual Studio Code, in the root folder of the Angular application, I am creating a new file named countries.json. Hope you are aware what JSON means. If you are not familiar with JSON, I will give a quick introduction about JSON in the next video. The content in this file is going to be the database for JSON server, and here is where we are going to define the country data. The data in this file has to be defined in JSON format. There are some specific rules on how the data should be defined in this file, and I am going to explain the format in which JSON server accepts data. The main content in this file should be defined as an object, hence including open and close curly braces. Within this object, I am including a property named countries within double quotes having an empty array as value. As per REST API standards, all resource names should be defined in plural, hence we have defined the property name as countries. As per JSON standards, it is important to define the property names within double quotes. This property entry for country means that this database is going to have data for countries. In this file, if I want to also include data for users, then I can include comma after country's definition. And I can include a new property named users having an empty array as its value. I just included users to demonstrate how different data representations can be provided in a single file. The empty array means that there are no data available for countries and users. Now I am going to include data for countries. Within the countries array, I am including a country object having ID as 1, code as IN, and name as India. Notice that numeric values are not represented with quotes and string values are represented in double quotes. This entry represents the data for one of the country with its country code and country name. The ID field helps to uniquely identify a country. To include another country, we have to include another object in the countries array. I am copying the first entry, then including a comma in the end, and then in the next line, I am pasting the next entry, then changing the ID as 2, code as US, and name as United States. Likewise, I can include any number of objects within the countries array. For now, I am going to have only two countries, so I am saving this file. Now, a JSON database file is created for JSON server, which contains data for two countries and no data for users. Create a new file named countries.json in the root folder and include data for country content based on the instructions provided in this video. It is not necessary to include users as I included it just for representational purpose. In the next video, I will give a quick introduction about JSON, and in the following video, we will start the JSON server using the data that we have defined in this video.